Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today, I am going to review my procedures that I go through when I'm soldering wire. I'm going to show you all the equipment I have and the various things that I take into consideration when I want to solder a piece of wire. So let's get to it. Let's go over to the bench here, and I'm going to show you exactly the tools I use for soldering wire, the reasons why, and maybe you don't have some of these tools, and maybe you do. You might pick up some tips, but I'm going to solder one piece of wire, and I'm going to show you a technique a lot of people have never seen before, and hopefully, well, maybe you'll like this video. So let's take a look right now. Well, let's start off with all the equipment I have. First of all, when you're cleaning your tip, this is the best kind that I prefer. This is just spun brass, and cleaning your tip in here I find is the best way, rather than using, you know, the sponge and the water technique. You actually need one of these for doing a lot of soldering jobs. When you're soldering a piece of wire, it comes in real handy. These third hand kind of deal here with the clips. And I use these ones here too. And these are small little pliers kind of thing. And I use them quite well. And I also use fine pieces of wire. I'll show you how I'm going to operate that. That's the tip of the day right there. And of course you can see your solder comes in various sizes and thicknesses, and you don't use plumbing solder. This is plumbing solder. You don't use plumbing solder. You use solder for electrical work. So you've got two different types. You've got rosin core and flux core. You want to go with this style right here. And you can see it says rosin core wire. Now, a rule of thumb for me, what I like to do is whatever thickness of wire that I'm going to solder with, I like to have roughly the same thickness of solder so that it doesn't take all day. I mean, if you have to solder a big piece of wire, the last thing you want to do is use a small little, you know, piece of soldering wire like this. I mean, come on, you're going to be there all day and you'll overheat your wire. And so what do I use for soldering? Well, this is butane, and that there is for huge big jobs when you're soldering, say, a connector on the end of a huge battery cable. This one here is a nice butane soldering torch for when you don't have electricity. This one here, well, it is pretty heavy duty, and it's electric, and it says 230 and 150 watts. So it's got a two-stage trigger on it. This is my favorite soldering iron, this one right here. And if we take a look there, you can see made in England. Now that particular one there is 25 watts. That's my go-to. That's my favorite one. That's the one I'll be using today. So let's get set up here. I'm going to put a piece of wire on here, and I'm going to talk about some tips that I've picked up over the years and some things that maybe a lot of people didn't realize what you can do and how much damage you could do to a wire just by soldering. So all we have right here is just snip, piece of wire, two lengths, and most people, what do they do? Well, they'll just take this one here, and just twist them all up, solder it, and Bob's your uncle. Well, sometimes that's not always the best thing, but for today we're only going to concentrate on just the soldering part, not on shrink wrap or whatever it is that you're going to put over top of this to cover your solder. Today I'm just going to show you what I do. Okay, so what I do is I get a piece of wire like this, just like that, and I take this piece, wrap it around with my fingers. I know it's hard to get in here with my fat finger showing everything like this, just like that. So that's what I've got right there. So now what I do is I move this on up over to here, just like that. This is where these come in handy, and as you can see, now you can bring it around, or you can use your fingers if you want, and you wrap it. So I can't show you exactly with my hands in the way, but I'll bring you back when this is all wrapped and I'll show you what it looks like. So that's it all wrapped up there, and all you do is you come in here with your small little snips and just snip these off. Okay, so now we're going to show you exactly how I solder. Well, the first thing you can see is you have to have actually a clean tip. And before you start soldering, you clean your tip. And before you put your soldering iron away, you put a little blob of solder on the end there, and that seals the tip for next time. So what do a lot of people do? Well, the first thing they do is they put it underneath here like this. They hold it to the wire, and then they start feeding the solder in. And actually, that's not such a great idea, because you're going to burn your wires on the bottom here 3 times the temperature or more before it actually starts to reach to the top. So it's best to just take a nice little blob of solder like this, put it underneath, and then just at the tip here, just start feeding it in until it conducts with the wire itself here. And then as you can see, it's starting to wick in. And I'm feeding it in the bottom, not on the top. And it's wicking along there. So now as it's hot enough, you can put your solder on all the way, and you only need enough solder till you see it reaches here and here. You don't got to keep pounding it on until you have blobs hanging off the bottom and everything else. So that's pretty well it right there. And that's a little, maybe a little bit different than you're used to seeing, but in reality, that's all you really need. And that joint there will never fall apart. It won't vibrate on a piece of machinery apart. It's on there for a lifetime. Well, I hope you found that interesting. And I just want to show you this wire once again here. And that's a close-up of it right there. And that is a really good bond. You guys leave me a comment below and let me know how many of you do that with wrapping secondary wiring around first. Make sure it's a good mechanical bond first, and then put the solder on. And same as soldering itself, you know, feeding it in from the bottom rather than overheating your wires on the bottom and then feeding it from the top. Is it that critical? For a lot of stuff that people are doing, no, it's not really that critical. But, you know, there's good, better, and best practices. Well, this is one practice that I think is best. And for a lot of you that are wondering, yeah, this soldering iron I've had, this one here, for over 25 years. And I made sure that when I bought it, well, of course, I bought lots of different tips. You use the tips up over the year, and I bought their tips with it as well. And that's 25 years. How many of you can get a soldering iron to last 25 years? So thanks for joining me here today, and I hope you found this informative. A little bit different way of soldering. Yes, you can just twist the wires, pound the solder to it, throw some electrical tape on, and Bob's your uncle. But you know what? Best, better, and you know what? Most favorable, you know, idea that you can use when you're soldering a piece of wire. And not everybody solders the same or really cares less, right? A lot of people just, you know, put a nut connector on it, tie it up, off you go, right? Well, I don't do that. I like to just take my time, do it what I figure is the best practice. So thanks for joining me here today. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. Come back again, and let's have some more fun. Cheers.